We've just looked at how to deliver flexible grid layouts of your data. Now let's look at data visualization. So recall that the difference between a data region and a visualization is that the visualization is fixed in dimensions. Mm-hmm. It's not going to grow in size or shrink in size as the report is rendered. On the Insert Ribbon tab, you'll find that there are these six data visualization templates: the chart, gauge, map, data bar, sparkline, and indicator. Let's start with charts. These are used to graphically represent your data. So all of the charts you can imagine from Excel, yeah, you have them here.
Yeah, the Excel charts are a good parallel here.
So we can produce something like this, a clustered stacked...
stacked bar chart?
I think it's a stacked column chart. Okay. That has data labels, even color conditional labels and a legend. Next, let's take a look at the gauge. Great for KPIs.
Yes.
When you're looking at a value and you need to compare it with status. And so there's some fairly good looking, I do like these still. These gauges allow you to define pointers to display your value across a scale and to superimpose ranges that convey status. All right, so we can see the range here for 80 is indicating it's in not a nice zone.
Mm-hmm.
Something's not meeting expectation.
Yep.
Next, we have maps that are used to spatially represent data. So what's good about this map is that it works directly with SQL Server spatial types.
That's true.
If in your source data you have data stored using the geography or geometry data types, then they can be rendered directly by this map. You can also work with Esri shapefiles, bringing in custom polygons, and Paginated Report Bear, there's a map wizard.
That's true.
All right, but it only works for the United States.
Oh.
Just as well, that's where you're from. So it supports associating analytic data sets, so you can superimpose data over your maps using bubbles and such forth, and lots of formatting options, including color and distance scales, legends, titles, markers, and tooltips. So here's an example of what your map might look like. And this was created by using the map wizard. And we've used color to convey the sales. The darker the color, the more sales have been achieved in that state. The next three sort of grouped together. These work very well inside of Tablix.
Yes.
So the data bar, sparkline, and indicator. Note that when you configure them, they must be based on the same data set that the Tablix is bound to. We use data bars to display a single data point, and it's rendered as either horizontal or vertical bars. So it's easy to see relativity. You know, when the eye is glancing at a column of numbers, mm-hmm, it's hard to see relativity. A data bar really pronounces this. And then sparklines are excellent when you want to see trend when you've got an axis of time.
Sparklines are a very popular ask in the Power BI service, and you can do that right here in Paginated Reports.
Well, what's the response if I want to do it in a Power BI report, Chris?
Use a paginated report.
Use a paginated report. So here is a unique strength of the paginated reports when it comes to sparklines. And then indicators are just like your traffic lights.
Mm-hmm.
Recall that in the demonstration, we had the status for the salespeople. Was it -1 off track, 0 off track, but not terrible,
mm-hmm,
and 1 on track? An indicator is an excellent choice to convey through color and potentially shape what the status is. So we could enhance our report by doing this, adding a data bar to see relativity, adding sparkline to see across the year what the progress has been, and then indicators as well. So how about we enhance our existing demonstration table with data bars and indicators?
That's a great idea.